charming, even when you're not around.
I was driving on the way here, and I heard something that really made me cry. Surprise. But I thought it was really interesting because I had a full circle moment. Because first, when I was getting in my car to come down here, I started thinking about learning. And I thought, not that I'm old or anything like that, but I thought, oh my God, these young actors have so, you guys, you have so much to look forward to in life. You're like all sponges. You're like a pure canvas of learning. That's so, there's so many things you don't know yet about yourself and about process and about life, myself included, obviously, but I just, you know, I am a little bit older, and so I was starting to think about that, and I was a little sad about it, because I remember when I was 20, and I was like, everything was like a whole new world, right? And now it's like, whatever, no. So I started thinking that on the way down, and I was like, well, what lesson do I need to get here? And I was listening to NPR. Ah, this is like amazing that this happened. So I'm listening to NPR, and they talked about, I don't know if you heard this, in the last few weeks, there is an indigenous tribe that was deep in the Amazon forest, and they made contact. So they're called a non-contact tribe, or an uncontacted tribe. And so there is this tribe that has no previous contact with civilization as we know it. And it really blew my mind. It's also a very sad story because they think that they have come from Bolivia, where, you know, with logging and drug running and a lot of other reasons that they kept getting this tribe. It's a very small tribe of like seven. They found seven people being pushed and pushed until they went to Brazil, and that's where they were found. And so they speak their own dialect. There were a couple other tribes in Brazil that could communicate with them, but not fully. So I just started thinking about, oh my God, you guys, we're living in 2014, and isn't that such a beautiful, it made me cry, because I thought, there are so many things we still don't even know about in the world that we like to pretend that we do because we're so data influenced. We can get information in a heartbeat, but there are still mysteries to be explored and unfolded. There are still things possible for us that oftentimes we get in a, conditioned way of seeing things. I get it, you wake up on a daily basis and you see your life the way your life looks in concrete terms, and it can sometimes get you down. And I think the point about this story is, wow, there's so much magic and possibility and things that we don't even know about, including yourself vis-a-vis yourself, who you are, what you want to do, how to create, what's possible for you in a career, how to make your dreams come true, even though sometimes they feel quite far and removed from that even being possible. So it's all possible. And then I started thinking about something that I had learned many, many years ago that I think supports this theory that I want to end with, because it really made me, I'm so excited about it. Really about getting out of our way and stop coming at life from that place of thinking that we know, because we don't. We just don't. So there is this saying that, a graph about, you know, the possibility of life. And so there is, okay, I made a little pie chart. Can you zoom in? Can you zoom in? So I made this pie chart and I colored it in the last 2 minutes. So let me show you what these three graphs mean. So if this is the totality of the universe or the world that we know, first of all, the yellow part is what we know. Okay, so I know that I'm a man and I'm an artist and I come from a European descent, right? There are certain factual things that you all know about yourself, okay? Then there is the orange graph. And the orange graph represents things that you know that you don't know. So in other words, I don't know about math. Well, I mean, I know math, but I can't do it. So I know that I don't know certain things. Physics, I like to think of myself as a weekend scientist, not really that smart. So there's certain areas and topics and subjects and things that I know are there, but I don't know anything about it. And then the last thing, which is where all potential exists, is what we don't know that we don't know. So you guys, that's amazing to me. That's possibility. That's an unheard of tribe revealing itself that we didn't even have consciousness of that existed. See what I'm saying? So there's factual stuff that we know, there's factual stuff that we know that we don't know, but then there's a whole, this whole magical fairy dust universe, parallel possibilities that exist that we don't even know of. You don't even know that you don't know it because it's not even part of our conscious awareness. That's where possibility exists. That's where we gotta go more in our daily lives. Stop letting the business and the way that the business comes at you get you in a lockdown of, I know, you don't know. If you did know, it would actually shut out, I think, the possibility of, you know, to me, the amazing thing about living in Hollywood is it can all change. It can all change for anybody in the room. So I think it's just important to remember that, and I just thought that story was a really amazing example of, it's like wide open spaces. You have to keep your heart open to wide open spaces. That's hard. You guys, you have to stay open. It's hard to stay open in the face of rejection, in the face of denial, in the face of people telling you no, in the face of people telling you you're not this enough, you're not that enough, you're not this, you're too old, you're too this. I get it. You must stay open. That's where possibilities find their way in. Okay? So that's my, I just was thinking about that on the way here, not really a lesson. So there you have it. Okay. Yeah, if you want to hear more about that tribe or, yeah. Now Google NPR, it's a really moving story. My God. These people are so innocent of the world that they all have captured the flu. And this woman who specializes in indigenous tribes, she talks about one of the greatest risks of, you know, tribes making contact is that they can become susceptible to all the diseases. If somebody's carrying a virus of measles, let's say, they have no immunization to it. It's quite tragic as well as beautiful. So anyway, watch NPR. Charming, even when you're not around.